Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to all of you. This is Spanish Language Series, Episode 47, The Present Tense Without Modal Verbs. So this is our outline for today, verbs conjugations in the present tense, more about stress on syllables, and vocabulary on high frequency verbs, Part 7. So let's start. Verb conjugations in the present tense. So to speak is hablar. So what happens is, words ending in a consonant in Spanish are stressed on the final syllable. So in the word hablar, the stress is going to be on the last syllable. I speak is hablo, he speaks is habla, and so is she speaks and you speak. Words ending in a vowel in Spanish are stressed on the penultimate syllable. So penultimate syllable means next to last syllable. So therefore, when I say I speak, that will be pronounced as hablo with the stress clearly placed on the penultimate or the next to last syllable. You speak in informal is hablas. You speak for plural is hablan. They speak is also hablan. We speak is hablamos. Spanish is español. I speak is hablo español. He speaks would be habla español, and so will be she speaks Spanish. English is inglés. So if I want to say you speak English, I'm going to say habla inglés. For informal, I'm gonna say hablas inglés. And for the plural, I'm gonna say hablan inglés. If I wanna say they speak English, again, it is going to be hablan inglés. And if I wanna say we speak English, it's going to be hablamos inglés. Okay, more about stress on syllables. So four words above are each stressed on their penultimate syllable, even though they all end in a consonant. So what happens is, what we discussed so far is, words ending in consonant should be stressed on the final syllable, but these four are the exceptions. So these four follow something known as Onus rule. So Onus rules rule tells us that words that end in N or S are exceptional, and they will be ending with stress on penultimate syllable. Okay, so following this rule, they speak will be pronounced as hablan with the stress placed clearly on the penultimate syllable. So if you want, you can pause this video, take this note, and then move on. Okay, so some more examples for you. If I want to say we don't speak English, I'm going to say no hablamos inglés. If I want to say they don't speak English, I'm going to say no hablan español. Okay, if I'm gonna ask a question, don't they speak English? It is going to be no hablan español. For plural, it's going to be no hablan español again. For informal, it's going to be no hablas inglés. And if I wanna say you don't speak English in an informal way, I'm gonna say no hablas inglés. No change in intonation, just simple sentence. If I wanna say she doesn't speak Spanish, I'm gonna say no habla español. And if I want to ask a question, do you speak English? I'm going to ask, habla inglés? Okay, now vocabulary on high frequency verbs, part 7. To finish or end is acabar or terminar. To follow or to continue is seguir. To forget is to olvidar. To forgive is perdonar. To get good marks is sacar buenas notas. Marks is notas, good is buenas. And since marks is feminine and plural, it is buenas. To get angry is enfadarse. To get dressed is vestirse. To get off a bus is bajar. To get on well with is llevarse bien con. To get up is levantarse. To give is dar. To give presents or gifts is ofrecer dar regalos or regalar. To give orders is mandar. To go is ir. To go along, like in a car, it's circular in coche. To go down or to get off is bajar. Okay guys, this was it for the session. I hope you liked the video. Thanks for watching and please subscribe to my channels. See you in the next episode. Bye.